From the students of Penn State Meteorology, here is your Penn State Campus Weather Service forecast.
Good afternoon, I'm meteorologist Ryan Morse. As we look out over Beaver Stadium, it's currently beautiful out there. It's 68 right now, with not even a cloud in the sky right now on our skycast. 68 with a dew point in the 60s, so it's definitely feeling comfortable out there. We have a calm wind too as well, and temperatures across the state for the most part in and around the State College, we're sitting in the upper 60s or low 70s. And as we zoom out to the rest of the state, we're sitting in the 70s for the most part, warmer south and east towards Philly, sitting at 77, with the upper part of the state sitting in the upper 60s. So right now on satellite, we're not dealing with much clouds at all. Maybe some clouds over by Lake Ontario, but that's about it. So we look countrywide, our next system is making its way from Michigan, and this will be our next threat of rain in the next coming days. As we see this clouds start to build in Wednesday, tomorrow, some spotty showers in and around center Pennsylvania, but nothing to be too concerned about as they keep pushing through the area. We still see these lingering clouds going into Thursday and then into Friday. And if we look off to our bottom right off the screen, you start to see those clouds. Those clouds are actually associated with Hurricane Dorian. We'll see those high cirrus clouds, but again, Hurricane Dorian's not really much of a threat for us, and we will likely see minimal to no impacts at all besides these high cirrus clouds making its way ahead of the system. So Hurricane Dorian has been the main system so far we've been talking about for this week. Currently, it's been downgraded once again at Cat 2. So it's been spinning over Grand Bahama for hours now. It's only moved about 30 miles in the past 24 to 36 hours. So Grand Bahama's been just getting absolutely blasted. But as we see, the forward speed has increased. We're now moving at northwest at 2 miles an hour, but it is a weaker system. But with that weaker system has had that wind field expand. So the system's gonna start to track to the northwest, as we said. It's gonna stay off the coast for Florida, but that wind field may clip eastern parts of Florida, so we may see those tropical storm force winds. But the bigger threat is gonna be to the Carolinas. We may potentially see a landfalling hurricane. North Carolina will be there by Friday at 8 a.m., and that's when we'll also start to see those higher clouds from the system making their way to State College. So for today, we're going to expect temperatures to reach 80 degrees. We're going to burn off that morning fog, and it's going to be mostly sunny and beautiful for the most part of today with that southwesterly breeze. But for the rest of the week, we're going to have temperatures start to dip into the mid-70s come Thursday, Friday, and Saturday. And Saturday is looking to be a beautiful one. It's going to be 74 and clear skies for our game against Buffalo.